according to you, is so unique about this hospital, and how has your experience been working in this hospital?
I joined here as a junior doctor way back in 1993, and the intention was to work here for 6 months and then go back to my village and start my private medical practice. But I had opportunity to visit one of our slum projects. It was a fairly new project by then, and then I decided to stay back and work for the slum healthcare project. And since then I was given various opportunities, various profiles to work. The first one obviously was to the was of the medical officer here in the hospital, then the in charge of slum project, slum health activities, and later I joined the public relations and fundraising department as director resources for this non-medical projects. The uniqueness of this hospital is basically it walks the talk, like providing quality healthcare to the last person, the bottom of the pyramid, in at an affordable cost. And the other thing is that the story doesn't end here. I mean, we take it to the transformation to the different fields, like education, then livelihood security, empowerment, and so on. So, holistic approach towards development, starting with healthcare, is the bottom line for all these projects. Most of the, all of them were doctors, so it was a, and it still is primarily a healthcare organization, but it has taken the healthcare to various fields of life. And the work which was started in as a small hospital not only grew vertically, but at the similar pace it also grew horizontally. So we have a, always a debate going on, horizontal growth versus vertical growth. So whenever a department is added to the hospital, one or two community projects are added to the fold. Currently we are working with 42 different developmental projects in around 120-130 villages and 40 slums of Aurangabad. So the idea is to provide quality medical services, quality primary medical services at the doorstep, with a special focus on maternal and child health, with a special focus on preventive health, and then convert that trust or utilize that the bond, use that bond to bring on the transformations in other sectors. So necessarily, initially necessarily we were health people. We started with healthcare activities in villages and slums also, but later we had different models of development, but still people know us as Hedgewar Hospital.
Okay.
So may it be a Gotari project, may it be a livelihood security for rural women, may it be forest conservation projects, what people know is Hedgewar Hospital is doing that. Technically,
right,
the hospital doesn't do this. Hospital has a team of doctors and social workers, and then a structured project implementation team is there. So holistic approach towards development and using healthcare to bring in the social transformation is the key. I think that's the point of highlight for this organization.
How's your experience been working here?
Oh, it was great. It's a great journey. I really feel fortunate to get the opportunity to be here, work here. It was not a pre-decided factor that I will come and join. Unless the founder, unlike the founder members, they had the, some sort of roadmap in their mind about dedicating their entire life for the this project of the hospital. When I joined here as a junior doctor, and then later when I got the opportunity to visit the slums and work there, I realized that I must stay here. Otherwise, I had a very, by then I had almost the setup of my private clinic 300 kilometers from here, where there was no doctor in many, many villages around. So I opted to stay back. I stayed here in the slum, and then it was getting involved into various activities, other or even other than health activities, gaining the trust of the slum dwellers, and then taking it to the developmental projects. So there were some challenges. It wasn't rosy at all the times. But later on, once we gained the trust of the local community, it became much easier. And then we moved on to different projects. By 2008, there was a need to somebody coming from the community project background and support Dr. Pandare for public relations and fundraising. Mm-hmm. So I was again chosen to do that work. And I still live in the slum. My wife is in charge of the adults and girls project and the skill development project for women. So for me, it's a very close to her topic, the slum development and the entire developmental projects by this organization. And I'm really proud that I had some role to play in building up the organization, the second organization, which now takes care of the social projects, basically, one of the three organizations.